In other news, as the debate rages over how assets worth more than a lakh crore of the Padmanabhaswamy temple be used in Kerala, the Maharaja of Travancore, who also heads that trust, has told NDTV that the wealth belongs to the Lord, but that he also shares the views expressed by many that it can also be used for humanitarian purposes. The Supreme Court had recently ordered an audit of the temple treasures after a petition was filed seeking greater transparency in the temple's administration.
The Sree Padmanabhaswamy temple in Thiruvananthapuram is now the center of international attention after assets worth over a lakh crore has been found in the temple. The Travancore royal family has been custodians of this assets for centuries. We have with us the Maharaja of Travancore, Sri Uttradam Thirunal Marthandavarma. Sir, tell us the deep association that the Travancore royal family has had with the Sree Padmanabhaswamy temple.
It is not in the past tense. It is in the past tense, the present tense, and we hope the future tense. It is our life. Everything that we hold is because of that. That is all that I can say, because the rest, as an Indian who has a little knowledge of law, when a thing is in court and subject to say, nothing is to be said.
Another interesting facet is that the Travancore royal family in the 18th century, yes, they had dedicated the kingdom to Lord Padmanabha and wished to be called as the Dasas of Padmanabha. Can you explain to us that concept, sir?
As I've just told you, when Travancore was molded into what is now an area of 7,400 square miles, my ancestor, Aniram Thirunal Marthandavarma, having melded it into this unit, he wanted to take no credit for war, skirmishes, whatever it is. And so he dedicated in 1750 himself, his family, his people, Padmanabha at his feet, and from then on he took on the greatest honor in the world for us as being his dasas. That's all.
Okay. So does that mean that you are only the custodians, the temple, the assets, the kingdom, you are only the custodians and it all belongs to the Lord? Does that mean?
Of course, everything belongs to the Lord. As they say, to attract tourists, okay, it's called God's own country. Is there any country which is not God's? Please sit down. So that's all.
And about this unearthing of this so-called treasure, many diverse opinions have come in. Some say that, you know, it should be, some part of it should be used for humanitarian purposes, like helping the poor, setting up hospitals and all that. I think that is also a concept that you would agree to. What is your view on that, sir?
I have the same opinion, but I am silent. Okay. No comment, nothing will be said. Okay. Because that is against the tenets of the principles of somebody else's law which has been entrusted on us. We had Manusmriti, the greatest lawgiver in the world, but we now prefer to follow Western systems of jurisprudence. That doesn't matter.
Okay, sir. And has the government been in touch with you when, after these recent developments, consultations have also happened with you, both regarding the historical perspective as well as...
When things happened, you would already know.
There you have it, the Maharaja of Travancore, Sri Uttradam Thirunal Marthandavarma, telling us about the deep association that the royal family has had with the Sree Padmanabhaswamy temple. In Thiruvananthapuram, Suvi Vidyadharan, NDTV.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.